Hello guys, today I'm going to show you guys how to shoot a portal gun bullet using Unity game engine. Just a quick note, this is part 2 of the how to create a portal gun using Unity, so if you're new and don't know where to start with, please check out part 1 in the description down below or in the top right corner. Now let's get right into it. Firstly, let's create a script called bullet. So let's create a C# script and name it bullets. Now let's wait for it to process and then double click on it to open. Go to our portal gun project and now type static public game object portal gun. And then we create a new method called start method, which triggers every time we start the project. So void start, we want our portal gun to be this game object that we assign the script on, which is currently our portal gun right here. And we use static variable because then we can access it between many scripts. So let's control S to save the program, and then in here let's just delete the start method for now. In the update method, we want our transform dot position is plus equal to transform dot forward multiply with time dot delta time multiply with our bullet speed. And here let's set our float bullet speed and set it to 40. And we use F at the end of the number because we want to the Unity to know that this variable is a float. So now we don't want our bullets to move forward in its direction, but in our portal gun direction. So to access a public static variable, you just need to name the script, which is portal gun. And dot, and we have Unity also autocomplete for us right here, which is our portal gun variable. So equal to dot portal gun, and then because we want to access the transform dot forward of that game object, so let's put a dot right here, and there we go. So now, if we run the program, you will see that, but the bullet still doesn't change its position. That's because we haven't assigned the script to our clone bullet. So to assign a script to a game object, just do clone bullet dot add components, and here we want to add our bullet script and add two brackets at the end with a semicolon. And now, if we run the program again, you'll see that the bullet is moving forward in our portal gun direction. And to make this a bit more realistic, let's put a rigid body component onto our bullets, and then let's test it. So as you can see, our bullet is falling down. And yeah, so, but if you shoot it to the floor, you can see that it's not disappear. So to make the bullet disappear when touch walls or anything, let's create a new method called onCollisionEnter, which detect collision between game objects. So now we want that if collision.collider, which is the object that collides with our bullets, dot name dot tag, it's not equal to portal gun tag is not equal to portal gun, then we want to destroy the game object. So destroy game object. So now, let's go back to our script. And then, let's add a tag to this, which is partial gun. And then, you add this tag to our partial gun. And these game object as well. So when you run it, you'll see that our bullet disappeared when touching the floor. So you can see in the hierarchy that our bullet flown, it disappeared right when it just
This is the end of this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed, and in the next video I'll show you guys how to create a portal after the bullet lands, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.